In U.S., the endemic zone will be Central North America, like Mississippi, Chicago, Missouri, around that area. Route of infection, inhalation, then spread with the lymphatic to IE system. This kind of pattern will be similar to talalomycosis, very similar, except the pathogen are different. Incubation period vary depends on the host and the amount of the fungus. It can be acute and self-limited, ก็คือหายเอง, or chronic or disseminated form, depends on the host. So this is the same. This one just show you that it can be in the cave in environmental form. Nothing important in this one. Here I would like to share you how poor of this man. All of this picture are the host are the AIDS patient, AIDS. Yes. It can infect the oral cavity. But with the AIDS patient, candida are the highest and growth rate is faster than histoplasma. So we found only the candida in the oral cavity. But you are the dentist. Yeah. You might have chance to find, to have the crystal histoplasmosis in the mouth. Yeah. So whenever you deal with the patient, please have the infectious control or prevention yourself. And this case in here in the lung and disseminated to the skin. This one too, the case in our hospital, already disseminate. Yeah. What is the symptom? Immunocompromise first, then everyone going to sleep. Fever, cough, and chest pain. Recurrent pulmonary. Another thing is that younger child and adult or especially aging people, yeah, are the victim of this disease. Another thing that I would like to mention is that here, fever, weight loss, okay, hematomegaly or splenomegaly, because when infected, all the system are really poor. Anemia, leukopenia, thrombocytopenia, elevated hepatic enzymes. And histoplasma is different from talaromycosis because histoplasma love to stay in adrenal glands. It's possible to find in adrenal gland, whereas talaromycosis, we never find the organism in the adrenal gland. So sometimes the ID man, infectious disease man, will send us the fine needle biopsy from the adrenal gland to do the culture or do the PCR. Skin test now, not so much, because skin test you have to induce by the antigen, so it's not so safe. The early robust of the pro-inflammatory by the Th1 and Th17 now is something that have the high impact to prevent. Normally, when the fungal infection, which T helper cell will react? T helper 1, right? T helper 1. If the balance of T helper 1 not good, or T helper 17 not so good, then the infection will be aggressive. The screening test can use immunodiffusion test as a screening test because have a two typical bands, H and M band. Whereas complement fixation test 1801 32, yes, is a presumptive evidence. If we check the paired serum and the test is become red or higher than 2 times or 4 times, it becomes better or it becomes worse. Okay? How about the laboratory test? Correcting the specimen. Where is the collecting specimen? Where? Oral cavity. Then lymph node. Then bone marrow. Then blood. If the infection manifests on the skin, we just scrape the skin and do the stain. Which kind of stain? Not KS preparation, no. We are going to use rice stain or kimsa stain. Because the organism is inside the cell. If you use a KOH preparation, it's not easy to find the cell. Or gomori methylamine silver stain. You can see intracellular budding yeast. Okay. Please do remember intracellular budding yeast. Whereas thyromycosis will be intracellular but different form. Now the picture here, intracellular, and now it's budding mother cell and daughter cell. With the right stain, yes, it become like this, like a sickle, like a seal present, like here, the very typical, like this one. The size is also need to note. Okay? Culture is a standard. Yeah. We need to do both temperature. But at 25, it's quite easy to get the culture than the 37. DNA probe, no, not so much. Yeah. Exoantigen test. Because of histoplasma and tularomyces, it is quite dangerous organism. We need to have the biosafety level 3 in US, but in Thailand we don't have in all the university, so we use biosafety level 2+. In US, whenever they are suspected to have a thermodimorphic fungi, they are not going to use, not to contact, not to do the lactophenol cotton rubet mount. They use only serological test because they are afraid of infection. Histopathology also similar, intracellular. Antigen test, now we can use urine and blood, both. Antibody test, it also available, but in Thailand most of us we use staining and culture. Here mold form have a tuberculate. This is a very typical tuberculate macroconidia of the histoplasma, but the yeast form will be budding yeast cells. This is typical. But the infected form of the mold form will be small spores. Now we change to the sister tularomycosis, caused by tularomyces manefii. The bamboo rat contains a lot of tularomyces. It's a natural source of this fungus in internal organ. Okay? In 1984, there are 5 cases reported from Thailand. But before that, in 1973, there's the first case imported to North Carolina. And after they found out, because this is a quite strange disease for the USA, they don't have this disease at that time. So they found the history of the patient. They found that the patient came to visit Southeast Asia And then when they went back to North Carolina, they have the infected case. That's why now more of the American, they used to, and they do not afraid to visit, especially the northern part of Thailand, which is the endemic zone of the tularemiasis. Don't forget, important is that tularemiasis of Penicillium manifei can cause competent and compromised host. CD4 less than 100. Endemic area is our country, Southeast Asia, Northeastern India, South China, and Northern Australia. Indonesia also a lot. Myanmar a lot. Okay, na? Here, huh? The red color show you the endemic zone of the Penicillium manifei. And the animal that related to this disease or associated is bamboo rat, or in Thai we call tua on. It's in the internal organ of the tua on. And normally the bamboo rat not running on the floor or on the soil. It is in the cave. So we still have less idea or almost no idea how the tularemiasis in the rat, no, in the bamboo rat, not the rat, okay, in the bamboo rat can infect in the human being. One thing, it might because of the air, the wind. The second might be some insect or some parasite. You still have no idea. The symptom very similar to histoplasmosis, fever, anemia, weight loss, skin lesion, very similar, fungemia. So the clinical manifestation very difficult to differentiate. So we have to culture, or we have to ask the history as a guideline. Then we have to do the histopathology, or we do the serological test. Specimen, which kind of specimen? Yeah. Fungemia, the blood. And normally the Penicillium manifei or histo will come to visit the doctor when it already disseminated to the skin. Don't forget, okay? Histoplasmosis specimen can be bone marrow because of these two diseases love to be in RE system, electrical endothelial system, okay? In bone marrow, in lymph node, in blood, okay? And at last, it disseminates to the skin. Direct examination should be right stain and confirm with the GMS, because right stain and GIMSA can observe the tissue reaction, but GMS can see only the cell. Culture is diagnostic of choice. Treatment now fungicidal amphotericin B, then follow with itaconazole. Both of the disease, histoplasmosis and tularemiasis, are very similar. Show you the umbilicated or kai kasadu ka. Hen mai lesion kai kasadu ma. Molluscum like lesion. Then you have to scrape in this area, in the center, until you get some bloody sample. And then smear on the slide or inoculate on the in the blood plate. Here like this. In the histoplasmosis, I told you already that intracellular budding yeast, but for tularemiasis will be, what is this? Not budding, but it's fission yeast. แบ่งครึ่งค่ะ Fusion yeast and each part will be separate and grow until mature. After it mature, it have a fission again. So this is how it multiply themselves. The mold form, just like a finger here. At 25, at 35 will be fission yeast. Okay. Here, the fission yeast. Okay? And now, histoplasmosis in the mold form doesn't have any color. For tularomyces at 25 degree on the separate dectus agar, we have the red color, okay? Red cerebral color, like a red wine. This is very typical. And the sporulation just like a finger like this. Like a finger and have a spore. Okay, นะคะ. Now we finish thermodimorphic fungi. We become into the monomorphic fungi that have two diseases. Septate, caused by septate hyphae, and non-septate hyphae. For the mostly highest incident of the fungus is caused by Aspergillus group. We call the disease as aspergillosis. And the non-septate hyphae, we call the member of the mucormycotina group. So the disease called systemic mucormycosis. The psychomycosis is a former name. Now it's out of order. We not call psychomycosis anymore because of the reclassification of the organism. Not only the aspergillosis, not only the Aspergillus fusarium, Scedosporium, also cause the hyophomycosis, or cause the systemic mycosis. The tissue form now, you study yeast, right? Will be budding yeast. Histoplasma, tumor dimorphic, will be intracellular, budding or fission yeast. Now, the higher, now the monomorphic mold will be, tissue form will be septate hyphae or non-septate hyphae, depends on the pathogen. In case for the aspergillosis, fusariosis, and scedosporidiosis, tissue form will be septate hyphae. No sporulation, okay? Only the septate hyphae. And the patient will be highly, the highest risk will be the neutropenia because the poor neutrophil cannot kill the fungus. Aspergillus fumigatus is over 90% of the pathogen in aspergillosis, especially in invasive aspergillosis. The second line in here are the aspergillus that have resistance to several drugs. That's why we have to separate at least the morphology of the aspergillus to help to guide the doctor to select the antifungal antibiotics for treatment. Unfortunately, Aspergillus fumigatus is the thermotolerant microbe, and it can be found in the bird, in the gastro, ในท้องเบิร์ดท้องนกค่ะนะงั้นมันสามารถบินก็ไม่ได้สูงนะ So this is how we can differentiate Aspergillus fumigatus easily intubate in 45 degree. If it can grow, it might be Fumigatus complex. Inhalation of the cornea into where? Into the lung. And get like a ball, aspergilloma. The patient of the neutropenics, the aspergilloma, the spore inside, can invade more and produce invade by septate hyphae. Okay? We inhale the spore inside our lung, and then the spore terminate as a septate hyphae. And the septate hyphae invade into several organs. Okay? And this kind of disease are easily found in the construction high building or any place that have the air condition and not clean air condition. Now it's a big problem of the high and close using the central air building. Several clinical manifestations like bronchoalveolar aspergillosis, allergic, we call APA. Whenever you go inside this, there are some certain room, the atopic or conchipair can differentiate, okay, this room have some strange, some aspergillus, and then they will cushion, they will just jam and jam and jam. So we can use all of them, all of this population, to check as our biomarker. No, I just say something bad. Lap lap, make it point. In some certain room, when they have the old or have air condition contaminated with aspergillus, when the atopic patient come inside the room, they will be very sensitive. So we have to aware of this patient, okay? Next, it can infect. And aspergillus, another typical is aspergillus can invade into the blood vessel and become thrombosis, clot into the blood vessel. And the most popular is in here, sinus. Become sinusitis. So we have to differentiate whether the sinusitis caused by the septate hyphae or by the non-septate hyphae. This is very important point. It can cause several infections in any organs. Ocular, invasive, pulmonary, cerebral. ได้ทุกออร์แกนค่ะ host defense innate immunity whenever you have the innate poor you have to very aware of the fungal infection for the EORTC European Organization of Research for the Treatment of Cancer in Europe they are very concerned of the criteria to differentiate aspergillus because they pay a lot for the social security so they have to have the criteria whether it is a possible infection probable infection or definite infection so these are the criteria of the infection here proven they have the culture and then they have to have the radiological positive culture it will be proven probable and possible the degree will be a bit less for the probable maybe evidence of saliva of direct examination for possible might be only some x-ray, no culture or no serological test. So these are the criteria how the patient will be treated or will be classified or will be put in a special room that have a HEPA filter or not. Here, inhale, then into the lung, spore germinate and can invade into another tissue. At the same time, yes, you after invade, the tissue have the reaction. You get the harrow and inflammation. So the inflammation, it doesn't mean that the fungus invade, but it can be the tissue reaction from the fungal infection. Okay? Here, this is the cartoon. When the spore in here, adhesion first. After adhesion, invade phagocytosis, and at the same time, the fungus will, the Aspergillus will produce galactomannan or other antigen or toxin as a virulence factor and cause the disease. And some of the fungus of the spore will be germinate into here, into the blood vessel. Yeah, germinate into the blood vessel. At the same time, produce gliotoxin to kill, to destroy the immune system. These are the big cartoon of the aspergillosis. Not only that, do not frighten with this light. This one, I just show you that. In the center are the mechanism of the aspergillus and surrounding in each color. Is each mechanism, they already study which kind of gene that related to, for example, of the cell wall, they have several kinds of genes that related to the virulence factor. You do not need to remember the surrounding, but at least in the center, you should understand which factor that related to the pathogenesis. The specimen, you can doubt, right? Sputum, serum, BAL. KOH preparation now help you. Because you can see septate hyphae here. The septate hyphae. And sometimes in the lung, we can see the conidium. Here, the vesicle of the aspergillus, which is a typical structure of the aspergillus. In the direct examination, normally, commonly, we found only septate hyphae, like direct examination. But for the culture, several kinds of the vesicle and structure of the conidiophore is different, and the color is different too. Here, we can see the vesicle and the structure of the conidiophore on the top of the vesicle arranged in a different way. The coronae also different. So this is a guide for us to identify and report the doctor. So the doctor do understand how to select the antifungal to treat the patient. Because Aspergillus fumigatus is very easy to treat. Even we say easy, it's difficult to treat. But other than fumigatus is more difficult to treat the patient. The last one will be mucormycotina, non-septate hyphae, okay? That is a septate hyphae. The disease is quite similar. Aspergillus love to be in the sinus tract, right? Non-septate hyphae also. But the different thing is that mucor or the member of the non-septate hyphae love to be in the patient who are DM, diabetes, in underdeveloped country or in the developed country like in Thailand, in India, in Mexico. The patient with the DM is the high risk of mucormycosis. But for the developed developing country for the already developed, like in England, in Italy, in US, most of the risk factor is cancer, malignancy. So the underlying disease is quite different from country to countries. For the non-septic HIV, now Dr. Kwan Chung divided into two big groups in terms of the medically important mucormycotoxin and entomopteromycotoxin. Almost finished. Just a few minutes, okay? I know you are very bored. The serious bear of this mucormycosis, okay, in subphylum mucormycotoxin. Mucormycosis mainly affects people with weakened immune system and can occur in nearly any part of the body. So very similar to aspergillosis. So important thing is you have to really diagnose one thing. Another thing is that mucormycosis is acute infection, whereas aspergillosis normally is chronic or subacute. The victim or the host, very similar, leukemia, lymphoma, AIDS, immunosuppressed therapy. But I try to help you to differentiate, okay? For mucormycotoxin, typically, I just said that, similar to asper, right? In sinus. But for this one, will be rhinofacial cranial syndrome. This is the keyword of the mucormycotoxin. Rhino, where? Here, right? Rhino, cranial, facial, right? So it's nose and then what? Surrounding the eyes. And then you block the blood vessel, the big blood vessel, then patient will become died. Not only in here, it can inhale into pulmonary and then go to the GI and cutaneous form. This is quite different because aspergillus is not inhale. It just invade. Okay. We cannot isolate mucor from the bloodstream, and very rarely to isolate aspergillus in the bloodstream. Okay? พูดง่ายๆคือเป็นการยากมากในการที่จะแยกตัวเชื้อ non-septic HIV จาก blood ถึงแม้ว่าจะเป็น invasive ก็ตามเพราะว่าอะไรเพราะว่าขออนุญาตอธิบายแบบภาษาไทยเนาะเพราะว่าตัว non-septic HIV เนี่ยพอมันถูกกระทบนะคะไซโตพลาซึมมันจะหลุดออกไปเพราะมันไม่มีตัวกั้นนะคะอันนี้คือตัวหนึ่งจำเป็นมากนะนี่อย่าลืมนะคะ so you can see here rhinofacial and pulmonary you have to really differentiate because the drug for aspergillosis and mucormycosis are differentAbsolutely different, okay? Amphotericin B are similar because it's fungicidal. Voriconazole for aspergillus will be okay. Will be just okay. But it will not get any good treatment for mucormycosis. So diagnosis will be very, very important.And you can see another thing is no typical symptom again. No typical symptom. Sorry, fungus is poor. really no typical symptom for any disease. Risk factor very similar. And I just explained for you already that in India, in Spain, in Thailand, and in very similar for the DM as an underlying disease. Now, this one already explained. KOS preparation will be help you. But in terms of mucormycosis, will be non-septate hyphae in the tissue form. Aspergillus, which form? Septate hyphae. Okay. Negative for GM and BG. Okay. Galactomannan and beta-glucan will be negative for the mucormycosis. But in aspergillosis, galactomannan and beta-glucan will be positive. And it has the cut-off point over 80 picogram per ml of the 1,3 beta-glucan. It means positive BG. I think this one you don't need to. This one, no. Just for you as a gift. เพราะเดี๋ยวแลบมีใช่ไหมคะมีนะคะอันนี้ไม่ต้องเรียนเพราะว่าที่นู่นก็ไม่ได้สอนนู่นสอนมัน over นะคะ but I just would like to mention you may I have another 5 minutes okay yeah this one are the non-septate hyphae right but mucormycosis member yeah normally ในซากพืชซากสัตว์But for the entomopteromycotina, which are the non-septate, will be with the insect and amphibian. And not the systemic infection. Normally will be subcutaneous infection. Normally only. Mucormycosis, typical is systemic, but sometimes it can be subcutaneous. So the diagnosis, the identification is another important point. To help the patient. ค่ะ อันนี้เป็น differentiation of the mucormycosis and entomopathy. Right? You can see in here. Root of infection, mucormycosis will be inhalation. But entomopathy will be abrasion, some trauma. Habitat, no, distribution, mucormycosis worldwide. And entomopathy is our area, tropical and subtropical area.Okay, so you can study from this slide. I'm not going to share with you this slide. Actually, this slide is very, very interesting because the case is subcutaneous infection. Right? Subcutaneous infection, not mucor member. But this case caused by the mucor member. เข้าใจป่ะ? Uh-huh.And so the identification by the molecular or the culture will help this patient from infected with a very swelling subcutaneous lesion to become really better. At the infection time period, he could not open the eyes. Really, the eyes closed. But after we treat with the itraconazole and amphotericin B,Actually, amphotericin B really helped for this patient. But at the first time when he visit, yeah, they don't know which organism it is. So they use both amphotericin B and itraconazole. If you see this one, treatment for the mucor will be ampho and posa. Entomop will be itraconazole. And this case not caused by the entomop.But at the first time, because the patient come and the patient stay out of the Bangkok quite far away, so they have to give them both. However, the patient really become good and we are really glad, yeah, that this patient become really good and he can work as a driver and as a laborer. Okay, that's all. For the mucormycosis, it's really terrible like this. Chronic infection, sorry, before your lunch, give you the really bad picture. But I would like you to remember this suffering because you work with the oral cavity, right? With the sinus of the patient. So sometimes you have to really, they have the, some lesion or not, and help them to identify before you are going to treat them in the dental way. Okay?ก็คงไม่มีอะไรแล้วล่ะค่ะนะสไลด์ทั้งหมดที่พี่ให้เนี่ยช่วยไปอ่านเพิ่มด้วยโอเคไหมคะนะพี่พยายามจะทำให้หนูไม่รู้สึกเกลียดฟังกัสแต่ก็ไม่รู้ว่าทำสำเร็จหรือเปล่าถ้าทานจะไม่สำเร็จ